Well, good morning, everybody, and it seems like a long time since I've addressed you in our weekly assembly.
Some say love, it is a river that drowns the tender reed. Some say love, it is a razor that leaves your soul to
Now, the grade 10s are going to be excited today because they finished their mock 2 examinations, but unfortunately grade 12s are in the thick of it, so best wishes to you. In 1972, a professor at Stanford University in the USA undertook research on the concept of delayed gratification. Delayed gratification is the ability to wait for a period of time to get something that you really, really want. To perform the research, the professor set up something that became known as the Stanford Marshmallow Experiment. Children were given one marshmallow and told that they could eat it straight away if they wished. However, if they waited for a short time, they would be rewarded with an extra marshmallow when the adult came back into the room. Now watch the video of the research in action.
Good. Okay, so here's the deal. There's a marshmallow. You can either wait and I'll bring you back another one, so you can have two, or you can eat it now. So you can eat it now or you can wait and I'll bring you back two. Okay?
Okay,
I'll be back. Okay, so I have one marshmallow for each of you.
Okay.
Don't eat it.
And here's the deal. You can either eat it now, or you can wait till I get back, and you can have two. Okay?
Okay.
So eat it now, or wait till I get back, and you can have two. And I'll be back in a little bit.
If we wait, you'll get us two?
Yep, if you wait, you get two. Or you can eat it now, whichever you want. Okay? I'll be back in a little bit.
I'm gonna wait. But if you wait until she gets back, she'll give you two. She still won't give you two because you ate it. So I love it. And I didn't eat a single bite of mine. So go show her, okay?
Okay, so I have this marshmallow, and you can eat it now, or if you wait a little bit, I'll bring back two for you, okay? How you doing, Sam?
Good.
Good. Okay, well, I'm going to go and I haven't found marshmallows yet, so I'm going to look for some more, but you stay here, and if you haven't eaten that one, I'll bring you back another one, okay? I'll be right back.
Well, having watched the video, I wonder how you would behave. Some of you might even think that this experiment was in fact rather cruel. The children were very young, so how on earth could they be expected to wait? Of course, holding out for one more marshmallow isn't going to change the world. But if you look back in history, we can see examples of the power of patience and its ability to transform society. One such event is Rosa Parks and the Montgomery bus boycott. Shockingly, in the USA in the 1950s, racial segregation was the norm. According to local laws in the town of Montgomery, Alabama, African Americans were required to sit at the back of buses. If the white section at the front of the bus became too full, African Americans had to give up their seats. However, one night, the bus grew full, and an African American woman called Rosa Parks was told to stand up and give her seat up to a white man. She refused to move and was arrested. Her actions led to the organization of a bus boycott by local civil rights leaders, later supported and spurred on by Martin Luther King. At that time, about 3/4 of the passengers on the Montgomery bus system were African Americans, and the leaders asked all of them to stop using the buses. The boycott did not bring about immediate results, but required intense patience. It lasted for over a year until finally the bus company was forced to change its policy. Now, patience is something that we all possess naturally, but it is something that can be cultivated and improved upon. For example, if we practice making ourselves wait, we may find that we enjoy something even more because we have delayed it. Patient people are usually more able to accept delays and deal with problems without losing their temper or becoming anxious. I believe that patient people are usually more able to accept delays and deal with problems without losing their temper or becoming anxious. So my message to you is, let's try and spend the next few weeks in being patient. I'm sure that we'll all feel less anger and worry in our lives. One group within the school community who has been very patient are the head boy, head girl, and the prefect team. Although they are wearing their ties for the final examinations, which started this week, they have been patiently waiting for their badges, which are now in reception for you to collect. So wear them with pride, and thank you very much for being patient. Have a good week, everybody, and thank you.
Hello, everyone. We are extremely excited to announce the intra-mon for junior and senior committees has elapsed, and we are extremely excited to announce the much-awaited winners of this. Before we get to the winners, we would like to talk a little bit about what exactly happened in intra-mon. We had 4 sessions for the juniors and 3 sessions for the seniors with passionate debate and extremely enlightening topics, which the chairs of the committees will get to very soon. Thank you all for participating, making it so successful. Although there was a mild hiccup from the transition from online to hybrid classes, we're extremely proud that we got great attendance from Feb 2nd to 9th March and extremely engaging debate as well. Now I would like to hand it over to Shrey Kakkar, one of the chairs of the Junior Committee for Intra-mon.
Thank you, Srishti. Intra-mon Junior was an absolutely fantastic spectacle to watch and be a part of. We had enthusiastic delegates from the junior grades, which we were really excited about, and we're extremely proud of the fruitful sessions they bore. We discussed the extremely pertinent agenda of radical religious terrorism in the counterterrorism committee, and we're immensely proud to present Ruchi Singhal, the delegate of Pakistan from 8A Explorers, as a special mention. Moving on to Dave. Well done, Ruchi.
I'm not one for words, so without further ado, we will move on to the honorable delegate. The honorable delegate goes to Sneha Ganti of 8D, who was representing the delegate of Tunisia of Pioneer's House. Congratulations. Then we have the outstanding delegate, which goes to the delegate of Afghanistan. Congratulations to Varishka Pandey of 7C of Voyagers. Now over to Konik.
Now, delegates, for the most awaited prize of the Junior Committee of Intra-mon, the Best Delegate Award. Now, the Best Delegate Award goes to Anaya Singhania of Grade 8B, representing Explorers with the allocation of the United Kingdom. Congratulations, delegates, and keep on running. Now, I'll hand it over back to Shushi.
Thank you so much, Evie. Congratulations to all the winners and all the participants for making it such a successful and engaging committee. Now moving on to Ayush Manapat, one of the chairs for the Senior Committee for Intra-mon.
Right, thank you for that, Trishti. The Intramon Senior Committee was loads of fun, and I hope and it was an enriching experience for both the Executive Board and hopefully for delegates. We obviously talked about the Nigerian Civil War in the Historical Security Council, and while we did have an explosive ending with basically the whole continent of Africa being wiped off the planet Earth, delegates did learn how to think on their feet and come to diplomatic solutions, however undiplomatic they were. Now, for the special mentions, over to Tejasvi.
For the first special mention, I'm proud to announce that Aditya Pakal of Grade 9, who represented the country of France of Explorers House, has won Special Invention Award. Congratulations, Aditya. Now, I shall be handing it over to Ananya.
For the Honorable Delegate Award, we have the Delegate of the USA. Congratulations to Shinjuan Sana of 10th grade Explorers. Over to Ayush for the honorable outstanding delegate.
Thank you, Anand. For the outstanding delegate award, we have no other than Avi Kanduri, who represented Nigeria from Discoverers. Congratulations, Avi. Now over to Pranav.
Yeah, thank you, Ayush. So I'll be announcing the best delegate award. So in the senior committee for Intramon, the best delegate award goes to the delegate from Biafra. Congratulations, Joho and Dr. Warren from grade 10 of Pioneer's House. And congratulations to all the winners. Thank you so much for attending. I'll be handing it over back to Shashi now.
Thank you so much, Evie of the senior Intramon. And congratulations to all winners and all delegates who participated. Please remember that awards aren't the be-all and end-all, and we really encourage you to participate in more MUNs because we hope it was as much of an enriching experience for you as it was for us. I would like to thank Mr. Jerome for giving us this opportunity and for serving as our faculty advisor for MUN, Mr. Tarun, Mr. Naveen Tom, and Dr. Caroline for giving us this opportunity to help so many young minds grow, including us. And thank you all for watching this video, and keep munning.